misunderstood. Some say that he's up to no good around the neighborhood. But for your information, a lot of my brothers got education, education, education.
Hello everybody, my name is Josh Clark. Welcome to DeSinicism, that is DeSinicism.com. This is episode number 24. I'm going to talk a little bit more about materials, tools, and technology. Very briefly. So there is injection molding, we have rotational molding, but for the objects that have a fixed cross-sectional profile, extrusion is an easy way to get work done. Now, extrusion is pretty much like injection molding without the mold.
Plastic pellets or beads are automatically fed to a hopper. The beads, with the aid of gravity, drop down to a screw. The screw forces the beads through a heated barrel. The working action of the screw in combination with the external heat liquefies the material until it can be forced through a die, like toothpaste forced through the nozzle of the tube. Dies with different profiles can be installed to produce any form of extrusion that has a uniform cross-section and continuous length.
Thermosets or engineering plastics are often used in this extrusion process, though after thermosets are set, it's very difficult or impossible to reverse the chemical bond, therefore making very difficult to recycle or take into consideration when looking at the life cycle assessment. DeSinicism, a fusion of design and cynicism, is a philosophical position which questions the industrial agenda as well as tries to encourage purpose-driven and values-based work within the design community. DeSinicism.com is a division of Blockaway Innovation and is a global parent and supporter of UNICEF, which strives to ensure health, education, and equality for children everywhere.